I've been running in circles, jumping the hurdles, getting caught in that rush of doing so much. I'm feeling kind of worn out. All this checking the boxes, trying to be flawless, has me spinning my head.
One of the scribes came near and heard them disputing with one another. And seeing that he answered them well, he asked him, "Which commandment is the first of all?" Jesus answered, "The first is, 'Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength.' The second is this, 'You shall love your neighbor as yourself.' There is no greater commandment than these." Then the scribe said to him, "You are right, teacher. You have truly said that he is one, and besides him there is no other. And to love him with all the heart and with all the understanding and with all the strength, and to love one's neighbor as oneself, this is much more important than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices." When Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." After that, no one dared to ask him any questions.
Gotta keep it real simple, keep it real simple. Bring everything right back to ground zero. Cause it all comes down to this. Love God and love people.
When asked this important question, "Which commandment is the first of all?" Jesus responded with a clear two-part instruction. "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself." In case his followers had any lingering doubts, he added, "There is no other commandment greater than these." These instructions beg the question of how to know if we are loving God or our neighbor. That's a big question, but Jesus' answer provides four ways in which we can examine ourselves. I think Eugene Peterson's rendering of Jesus' response helps us to understand more fully. Love the Lord your God with all your passion and prayer and intelligence and energy, and love others as well as you love yourself. Let's spend a few moments sitting with each of these. God, how can I better love you with all of my heart, all of my passion? God, how can I better love you with all of my soul, all of my prayer? God, how can I better love you with all of my mind, all of my intelligence? God, how can I better love you with all of my strength, all of my energy? God, how can I better love others as myself, as well as I love myself? Along with the scribe in today's passage, may we truly understand that these are all much more important than whatever other attempts we could make to try and please God. It is in loving God and loving others that God is most pleased. That is how we make the kingdom of God visible right here, right now.
Knowing life will be found when love can be loud, because love is what it's all about.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. May your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours are the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, for by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Amen.
Love God and love people.